This is the third video about the best methods for oxidizing secondary alcohols to ketones. Here I present you some methods for oxidizing alcohols either with pure oxygen or with air. Although the strategy may look highly attractive at first sight, it is difficult to conduct safely on a larger scale. If the starting alcohol is volatile or if a flammable solvent is used, the gases over the reaction mixture can become explosive. Thus, either a non-flammable solvent must be used or the reaction temperature must be so low that no explosive gas mixtures can be formed. Oxygen itself is not reactive enough to oxidize alcohols selectively to ketones and must therefore be activated by a catalyst. For this purpose, usually some transition metal complex is required, and copper, cobalt, or molybdenum derivatives are the most common choices. Several other metals, however, can also be used. Here's a list with some current references for various catalysts. In addition to copper, cobalt, and molybdenum, also some noble metals, such as palladium, can be used. Noble metal catalysts are more expensive, but often less than 1% of catalysts is sufficient for given oxidation. Here are some more catalysts and some recent review articles. The main advantage of aerobic oxidations, apart from the ready availability of the oxidant, is that the only byproduct formed is water. In some instances, also hydrogen peroxide may be formed, but, as discussed in the first video, with the right catalyst, this hydrogen peroxide may also be used as oxidant. As already mentioned, one big problem of oxygen-mediated oxidations is the formation of explosive gas mixtures. A further disadvantage is the use of a transition metal catalyst, which must be somehow recovered from waste streams and removed from the product. Furthermore, an excess of oxidant must usually be used, unless special equipment for the precise dosing of gases is available. This is an old example of aerobic oxidation with elemental platinum as catalyst. The reaction would probably also work with less catalyst. In this example, again water was chosen as solvent and a water-soluble palladium catalyst was used to activate oxygen. The reaction rate could be increased by conducting the reaction at a higher temperature and pH. In this example, the oxidation was done in toluene in the presence of vanadium pentoxide as catalyst. Vanadium pentoxide is used for various industrial oxidations and amoxidations and should be easy to recover due to its low solubility in toluene. So, what are the potential side reactions of aerobic oxidations? One problem is that, with some catalysts, hydrogen peroxide can be formed during the reaction. The mechanism sketched here would be the classical radical chain mechanism of an ort oxidation, but in the presence of transition metal catalysts, the mechanism may be different. Hydrogen peroxide can form hemiacetals or acetals with the ketone, so-called ketone peroxides. These may precipitate or accumulate during distillations in the still and cause explosions or fires. Ketones with alpha hydrogen can form hydroperoxides by simple ort oxidation, even in the absence of any catalyst. These hydroperoxides can undergo further chemical transformations, in particular in the presence of bases, for instance into 1,2 diketones or carboxylic acids. Moreover, in the presence of copper salts, ketones with alpha hydrogen can be hydroxylated by oxygen. Finally, a large number of functional groups undergo transition metal catalyzed aerobic oxidation, and it must be seen for each specific starting material if the secondary hydroxyl group will be oxidized first. Closely related to transition metal catalyzed aerobic oxidations are oxidations with ozone, with chlorobenzene, and catalyzed dehydrogenations without any hydrogen acceptor. The latter strategy is currently being considered as a way to use organic compounds for hydrogen storage.